All right, it is time for some TV musings. Hey everyone, it is Shannon, and I'm super excited to be here today and to share with you this video. This is going to be some TV musings on shows that I watched on live television that have finished their season or series. I think it's actually all season. These are all shows that we're going to get more of, which is actually really great news because I ended up really enjoying all of them. Yay! So yeah, let's just get started. So first up, we have Annika. So this is a Scottish crime drama. I watched it on PBS, and it follows Annika, who is the new head of the Marine Homicide Unit in Scotland. And I just really enjoyed this. So she's a single parent, and she's a bit of a, it's a, she's an interesting combination of a bit of a tough cookie, but also kind of socially awkward. And she ends up, there's a lot of direct talking to the camera, and I think this is used as a device because that she doesn't have someone to confide in, so she confides in us, the audience. There are also lots of this is, it seems like a bit odd, but there's also lots of notations to Norse literature, like Norse mythology and like Ibsen plays and stuff like that. I think because I can't remember for sure, but I think one or both of her parents is Norwegian, and but she's was raised in Scotland, if I remember correctly. So for me, like, I really enjoyed the characters and the relationships for this one. The crime drama elements of it is not so much of a pull for me. I don't those stories, especially because it's a marine homicide unit, you're dealing with homicides, so that's not so much of something that I enjoy. But I thought this was done very well. Great acting, great locations, interesting characters. And she's also a bit socially awkward in terms of like with people, like, and then she'll say like to herself afterwards, I can't believe I said that, like that kind of stuff, which I thought was quite charming. And I really enjoyed that. I think it's also nice to have a crime show with a female protagonist. There actually, I think, are a fair amount, but it's not a genre I tend to watch a lot, but this one just blew me away. As I don't know if I mentioned, I watch this on PBS, and I just, you know, often when PBS has new shows, especially like the first season of a new show, I like to give it a shot. I gave this a shot. I loved it. I'm thrilled that I watched it, and it has been renewed for a second season or series, as they say, over across the pond. So yeah, that was Annika. Let me know if you watched it. I really, really enjoyed it. Next up, oh, and that's actually, so here's another photo that has more of the cast that is in it. Let's say, let's take, says, let's talk about crime. I'm not sure about that, so anyway, great show, really, really awesome. I also watched season 2 and 3. It's been so long that I've done a video about this that I ended up watching season 2 and 3 of Miss Scarlet and the Duke. I think I have mentioned this before, maybe in an anticipated TV and then also after season 1. This is a period piece. It's a historical mystery series following a woman who is a detective and becomes a detective after her father passes away. And then she is friends with someone who works at the as a police officer. He's got, I can't remember what his title is, but he's pretty high up, and they've been friends forever. But it's weird because I did feel like initially I kind of felt like she was his ward or something. But there is definitely romantic chemistry between them as well. So I, one of the things that I love about this is a, this is another sort of, I don't know if they were ever in front of stores that were this tall, to be honest, at night. But this is a sort of another vibe from it. Yeah, and I really enjoyed season 2 and season 3. Not quite as much as season 1. I thought they, you know, like, they need to do things and make the story go certain ways and make the relationships go certain ways. And then, you know, if they want to make that go longer, there's certain things that they do, so they do that, and I feel like they did that a little bit. But I still enjoyed the stories. I love the art design of the show. Like, it's just so beautiful. There's obviously lots of blue. And I love some of the things, like, she tends to wear the same dress all the time, because, like, you would. You know, like, Yeah, I just think, and they have an interesting dynamic, and they started throughout the season, started to pull in more stories around some of the supporting characters, and I thought that that worked out pretty well. But they did some things, I think the things that I'm not happy with this show are the sort of like push-pull on will they, won't they, in terms of the romantic chemistry and tension. And I kind of feel like I wish they would just choose, but I also know often they're not going to in a situation like this. So, you know, that leads to other, you know, situations. And also, I'm like, I also think it's really great to see her as, you know, a detective at this time. You know, you see the challenges that she faces being a woman doing this. And so I like that story as well, you know, and that some interesting, definitely got into some interesting situations. But I, sometimes the same, you know, the same tension points again and again. So I think, and I think that does tend to happen with series. But overall, I really enjoyed it. It has also been renewed. I think they announced season 4 at the same time as season 3. But season 2 and season 3 came out very, I thought they came out very quickly, like maybe even within the same year. I watched it on PBS, so it was after the fact, but it was another one that I really enjoyed. And then I watched, oh, this has the network right on it. The another one I enjoyed was So Help Me Todd. So this is a CBS show. I watched it on Global here in Canada. This follows a mother-son, and she is an established lawyer. He is a PI who lost his license and ends up working for her at her law, at the law firm that she works at. And so because he isn't affiliated, like he does not necessarily do things the way that you're supposed to do them, but he often gets results. And we also have this sort of like it's a bit of a comedy as well, in terms of like, you know, he knows all of the new things that she doesn't know about, like technology or whatever, you know, and so there's some comedy play that way. I really like the cast. We have Marcia Gay Harden. I forgot to look up the actor's name. He was in Pitch Perfect. And I think they have, like, it's a really interesting, and then there's also more in the family, more of his siblings or her kids, and then some tension, you know, because it, so it's kind of like a, I don't, it's like one of those things, like technically it feels like a mystery or a what's that called, a procedural, because they're lawyers, or she's a lawyer, he's a PI-ish, and he's an investigator, and so there's always a case to solve, and usually someone to help, and often, I do find, I like watching shows that are about helping someone, like right now I'm rewatching Burn Notice, and I'm like, oh yeah, it kind of has the same format, like there's a long arc story, but every episode they help someone. It's the same sort of format as like Supernatural. There's a long arc story, but every week they tend to be helping someone, and then occasionally you'll get an episode that's more actually about them individually, and I'm like, yeah, I just like shows that are like that. These are just different genres, and this one's a bit more of a dramedy family. Like, it's, I don't know, I guess it's a procedural with a fair amount of, like, dramedy type stuff. So, but I don't know, it feels more comedy than drama. So it's a comma. That's not a thing. Anyway, so I really enjoyed it. It's one of the very few shows that I started watching during the September 2022 fall new releases. I usually try and watch tons of them, but that just didn't happen last year. And so this was one of the only ones that I not only got to see, but I actually stuck with. And that being said, I think I've only seen about 60% of the show. I missed tons of it. It was a tough year, so I had to let that be. But I do keep an eye out for when they air it in reruns. Like sometimes at the same time slot, they still air it, even though it's like been finaled for like 2 months. And so if I haven't seen it, I just will watch that one. And because it's mostly, you know, a procedural, I find that that's fine. Like I definitely miss some big drama without question. I came back, I'm like, what, wait, how, what, you know, but I did see the season opener and the season finale, a fair amount, I don't know, maybe 60%, maybe 50, I'm not sure, it's on my spreadsheet. So anyway, but I really enjoyed So Help Me Todd, and it was nice to have at least one show last year that was a new start, and that I was able to sort of of stick with. I do like that. And, you know, a lot of TV stuff is changing. There's so much stuff on streaming. We get, you know, new shows every week, new episodes every week. So it's very different than, you know, fall being the time where everything comes out. But we still do get a fair amount of new stuff in the fall. And I do have it as a bit of a tradition to try and, like, check out all of the new shows. Maybe I should try and do that at other points of the year. Like, just be like, okay, like, you know, June 1st to 7th, I'm going to pretend it's, like, premiere week and watch, like, 7 new shows that are on streaming or something like that. I don't know. Maybe I should do that. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, but, yeah, so that was Self Help Me, Todd. And then we also have, this is one that I did jump into the second season of, which is not something I normally do, but we have Cobra. So this is a British show, Robert Carlyle, if you can believe it, Robert Carlyle. And I apologize, I did write down the woman's name, but I didn't have my device charged, so I don't have it here. I will leave it down below. I'll leave links to all of the shows down below. So this one is a political thriller, and Robert Carlyle actually plays the prime minister, and she is his chief of staff. So I came into season 2. Season 2 actually has, like, a subtitle. I think it was, like, Cyber Wars or something like that. And, oh, I forgot to say, So Help Me Todd has also been renewed, so yay for that. So this one I jumped into season 2. It's a political thriller. I had no idea what was going on the vast majority of the time that I was watching it, because it does really, even though I think it is a separate story start to finish from season 1, there is, like, a big event that happens. There is, you know, lots of investigation into what's going on. There is political I don't know what the right term would be. Lots of talking politics, talking about, like, what who could be responsible, what is the correct response, what will garner the most support in response versus what will gain what's the right thing to do versus what will get the most support, and how those aren't necessarily going to be the same thing. Also, like, you know, are people playing both sides in terms of certain situation? How did certain information get leaked out? These kinds of things. So it's a political thriller. Like, it's just, you know, that's it. I think that those are all elements of a political thriller. For me, I would actually say, like, one of the things I liked about this is that it had a female lead, because she really is a lead. He's the PM, but she is the protagonist, I felt, at least in season 2. I did really enjoy this, and it was a really, really well done show. The acting was great, the writing was great, I was really invested, it was really tough, like, it was really tense. There were some situations I'm like, I don't know how people are gonna get out of this, I don't know if people are gonna get out of this, and because I had no context of the first season, I didn't know if they would. But I will say, like, I didn't feel, now it's been quite a while since I watched it, and I did miss, I think, the 5th out of 6 episodes, but I didn't feel like it came to a great conclusion. I will say that. I didn't feel, like, I actually was like, was that, is it coming back after commercial? And I know it isn't, because it was on PBS, but I kind of felt like, what's going on? So that wasn't great, but I thought, with the exception of that, I thought it was very, very well done and a really interesting, engaging show with lots of great acting. So, and it has been renewed, or there is a season 3 or a series 3 confirmed, but it has a different title. So, like, the first one was just, I think, Cobra, and then it was Cobra Cyber Wars, and then Cobra something else. So, yeah, so it's, and I do feel like it's, and I hope it's okay to say that about, like, sort of how the season 2, I'm not going to say what happened at the end of season 2, but I wasn't terribly, like, I didn't feel like it came to a good conclusion, and that doesn't feel great after, like, for a political thriller. I'm okay with things being tough, or but I didn't feel it was very clear that it was done, and especially given the fact that each of the seasons seems to be a different, like, theme, I feel like it was very surprising. And I wish it was on one of the streaming services, because one, I would go back and watch that one episode that I missed, but I would rewatch it and I would definitely watch the first season. It's probably on now. There's a couple of new services added to Prime, like at least here in Canada, like Acorn, and I think there is a PBS one, so it might be available that way. I don't remember if it was available to purchase individually. Some of these shows, I think both Annika and Miss Scarlet and the Duke, I did miss like the finale, so I did end up buying it from Google Play just to like watch that one episode, because it's like $2 or something to buy one episode. So it makes me feel more like it's not a big deal. But I didn't do that with Cobra, and I think that was because I missed the penultimate. I thought, oh, I'll figure it out. As if. I think political thrillers and espionage are the two genres I have the hardest time understanding what happened. So, yeah. Anyway, so that's some of the shows that I watched live. Thankfully, these have all been renewed. So I imagine three of those are on PBS, although probably will be sometime. Oh, actually, I don't know. I have no idea. I think none of the release dates have been confirmed for anything other than I think, So Help Me Todd, it would make the most sense that season two would be in September 2023. And the rest, I just wait and watch on what's on PBS to see if it's going to be there. So there you go. There is some live shows that I watched. Let me know, have you seen any of these? Did you enjoy them? Do you jump into season two like I did with Cobra? I like doing that every once in a while. I do kind of feel like, you know, I've watched a lot of TV over the years. I'll probably be fine. I'll probably be able to figure it out. And with this one, given it's its own thing, it was no problem for the story. Definitely made it engaging in trying to figure out the relationship dynamics, which actually was kind of fun. So it was a win. So there you go. There are four shows that I watched recently. Let me know if you have seen or enjoyed any of them. And I will be back soon with another video. Thank you so much for watching. Oops.